Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com. Welcome back to the channel and welcome back to this awesome tutorial on Rebeloper Messages 13. Today I'm going to walk you through how you can set up Rebeloper Messages 13. So let's just dive into it. Okay, now when you open up Rebeloper Messages 13, you will be greeted with this structure or folder structure rather. The first thing you have to do is install the pods. Now you know how to install CocoaPods. Open up terminal, drag and drop the root folder and type in pod install as you can see here. Go ahead and take a look at almost any of my other tutorials on how to do that. I always do that on the first step. So, you already have your pods here in configured, like DuckUI, Swifty StoreKit. It uses Swifty StoreKit 0.15.0, Keychain Swift and Gifu. Well, Keychain Swift is kind of not that important, but we already have it here, so you might as well add it. So, after you run pod install, I won't do that because I already have it installed on this project. After you do run it, go ahead and take a look at these two setups. So go to pods project, DuckUI general, and uncheck app extensions, allow app extensions, API only. So let me just show you how that looks like. So the pods project, DuckUI general. So let's go to our pods project, DuckUI, and select general. So there we go. And just scroll all the way down here under deployment info, and app extensions should be unchecked. Do the same for layoutless, okay? Allow app extensions API only, let that be unchecked. Now, if you do not uncheck, this is checked automatically, but if you do not uncheck, there will be errors in your code. Okay, let's move forward. What do we have to do now? Well, all your setup is under the setup folder as usual. So let's go through them one by one. Here we have our assets. We have our app icon because as you know, we have a parent app and an extension app, the actual iMessage app. So here we have our app icon. In just a parenthesis, we need the main app to purchase in-app purchases because I believe as of 2 years now, you really cannot purchase in-app purchases in extensions. Okay, so that's why we have our main app. So we have our main app icon here. We have a background, images for the category one, category three, and category all. Now, as you can see, category two is kind of missing. Well, that's in the GIFs folder because the image actual icon for the category 2 is a GIF. Okay, iMessage app icon, of course, and all of our stickers. They are all PNGs, and of course, you may have GIFs too, or GIFs, whatever your preferred pronunciation is. So here we have our category 2 GIF and our sticker 16 GIF. Okay, so let's move forward. Rebeloper Messages 13 setup. Now, there is in a code documentation of what you have to do, but let me just walk you through it. We have already done this setup with the pod install and so on, and unchecking allow app extension API only. Now, it says do not forget to set up the in-app purchases in Rebeloper Store 5, Rebeloper Store Basic, Rebeloper Store Setup. Now, this is just here. So I have moved this to Rebeloper Store Setup. We'll do that in just a moment. Okay, let's move forward with our setup. In the main app, this lets you repurchase in-app purchases. Good for testing. Advised to set it to false before launch. Now, this is just an internal thing and a testing thing. Make sure you set this to false before you submit your app to the App Store. So purchase several times equals false then. Are all stickers free? Now, some of you have messaged me that maybe you just want to set a one-time payment for your iMessage app and you want to let all of your stickers to be free. Now you can do that here. All stickers are free, set to true, and that's it. You don't have to set up in-app purchases and so on. So that's how easy it is. Add your bundle ID amplifier. So app bundle ID is com.rebeloper, rebeloper messages 13. Now, let me be clear on this. Let's go to our project. And here we have our targets. First, we have our main app target, and that is what we need here. So com.rebeloper.rebelopermessages13. Of course, this will be different for your, and of course, the version should be one that is self-explanatory. Now, if you take a look at the extension, it has another bundle identifier, and that is not what we are talking about in that setup. So it's com.rebeloper.rebelopermessages13.extension. Of course, when you do change your bundle identifier, once you create your app in App Store Connect, and we'll get to that just in a minute, you need to change this prefix of com.rebeloper.rebelopermessages13. Leave the extension as is. So that's how I recommend it. So let's move forward. All categories. Now, this is something requested. So we should purchase everything with one in-app purchase. And this is a good logic to do so. So I have added an all categories in-app purchase. Of course, if you are not having everything for free. So make sure you do not change anything here. And of course, the in-app purchase in App Store Connect should have a suffix of all categories. We'll get that in just a minute. Now, here we have our categories. We just simply create category objects with a title, description, image URL. As you can see, it is category one. Now, image URLs are from basically the assets catalog. Let me just jump right there. Category one, it's the name of the image. You could use category two for the, there we go, image URL category two. And that is a GIF. That is perfectly fine. And yeah, basically that's it. We have set up our categories. Of course, if you want only one category, you can have only one category. Now, let's move forward with the options. In-app purchase prefix. Now, the first one for me is free. You can have that as free. But if you kind of sell these things, these categories, you can have the suffix. Now, the suffix is basically the bundle ID dot and this suffix. So that will be the whole in-app purchase ID set up in iTunes App Store Connect. So the bundle ID, com.rebeloper.rebelopermessages13, and of course the suffix category 2. And while we are here, let me just jump right there. So there we go, com.rebeloper.rebelopermessages13, category 2. And of course we have all categories. This is mandatory if you have in-app purchases. And as you can see, we have a category 3, there too. So there we have category three. Now the category image type, this is what type of image does this category icon or so-called is. So as you can see here, we have our category 2.gif. So we set this to gif. Image type here is plain because in the asset catalog we have our category three image. Okay, this is just a summary. We have to add all of our created categories under the staticlet categories. That is for internal use. Next up, we are going to set up our stickers. Well, that is pretty straightforward. We are going to create these sticker elements. And the first one is with the title sticker 1, image URL. That is basically the image name is sticker 1. Here we have our category, and as you can see, if you just scroll a little bit down, you can set category 1, category 2, and so on, which you have set up, if you recall. Now, the sticker type, there are three types of stickers. The first one is sticker. Well, basically, this sticker is when you just tap and hold your sticker, and you can drag and drop it onto the conversation. That is the first one. The next one is this iMessage one. And the iMessage is, if you recall, in some conversations, you have an image maybe, and that all of that is inside basically a bubble. And on the left, upper corner you have the icon and maybe the name of your sticker app. So that is the iMessage sticker type. And the next one and final one is the GIF or GIF, whatever you'd like, sticker type, which is basically not a PNG sticker. Okay, here we have all of our stickers in category 3, 15, or rather yet, I believe, yep, there we go, all of our stickers are here. And finally, we have to list our stickers. This is just for our code to work properly. Add all of your stickers here. Okay, basically, that is it. Please note that this last sticker is named 15, but the 16th sticker is in category 2 as a GIF. Okay, so just so you know. Anyway, you will have to set all of this up. Okay, we are done with our Rebeloper Messages 13 setup.swift file. Let's move forward and take a look at our Rebeloper store setup. And because Rebeloper Messages uses in-app purchases, of course you know by now, and it uses Rebeloper Store Pro, which comes basically free for you. You don't have to buy it. It already is inside Rebeloper Messages. And let's take a look at our setup. Okay. Now, you must create your in-app purchases in a certain way. And basically that is, we have to take a look at our suffix and our app ID. So our app ID, our bundle ID basically, is com.yourcompany and .yourAppName. Now, the suffix in our case, in this little case, is all categories, and if you recall, we have to create, this is obligatory if you want to have in-app purchases in your Rebeloper Messages app. So com.rebeloper.rebelopermessages13.allcategories, and this is a non-consumable. Now here you can see two other non-consumables for category 2 and category 3. Of course, I won't go into detail how you have to create in-app purchases. That is pretty straightforward. Make sure you create non-consumable in-app purchases. Okay, let's go back to our Xcode project and scroll a little bit down to take a look at our categories. We are going to create some registered purchases. And the first one is category all with an image URL of category all and the suffix all categories. And this is a regular. Again, please do not change this in-app purchase, this registered purchase at all. And make sure that you add it in the registered purchases array. Next up, we create our category 2 registered purchase. Pretty straightforward. Okay, and we add both, or rather yet, all three of our registered purchases into the registered purchases array. This is a list for the code to work properly. There are a few more things here in a purchases shared secret. Sorry for that. We don't need that with Rebeloper Messages 13 because we are not supporting auto-renewable subscriptions, which Rebeloper Store does support. So, finally, should log Rebeloper Store. Let's set this to true because, yeah, logging in your console, it's always a good idea to just know what is going on in your app while it's running. Finally, reset keychain. We can reset the keychain, set this to true, but make sure this is set to false before we submit to the App Store. And here is the steps you need to take in order to reset basically the keychain properly. Okay, we won't go into this, just follow along those steps. Okay, now one last thing, let's go back to our browser, and you already know how to make in-app purchases, and that is not the scope of this tutorial, but let me just show you a few more things that you need to be aware in App Store Connect. So go to your agreements, tax and banking, and make sure that you have signed the paid apps contract, maybe you need to set it up, make sure that everything is okay here under the paid apps agreement. Finally, go to users and access and to test. I know testing in-app purchases can be a pain, but to properly test in-app purchases, select the sandbox testers down here and create a brand new tester just for this app. Or if you already have it, maybe just use that one, but make sure that you do have a sandbox tester. And now let me just show you on my phone where you need to log in with your sandbox tester. Let's go to settings and select your Apple ID, select iTunes and App Store. Let's continue here. Let's just wait for that to initiate. We just need to sign in. Okay. Let's tap on it again and make sure that under Sandbox, as you can see there, Sandbox account, you have that test account that you have just created. Okay. And maybe sometimes you just want to, let me just go back. You just want to log out of your so-called real Apple ID. It can be tricky, but the most important part is that your Sandbox account is the same as the account that you have created here. Okay, now it's time for a little bit of testing. So let's go and build our extension. Make sure you select your extension, not the main app, but your extension and your phone here. There we go. It's launching. And as you can see, there are a lot of logs here. And it has failed to verify category field. No problem with that. If you have everything set up correctly, then you won't have any issues on a live app. So let me just tap on here to have some other stuff. Okay, there we go. Let me just use this one. Oh, you can't unlock this. You can unlock this in the main app. So let's just do that. And let's send this away. Okay. And basically that is it. You can test it. And let me just, before I leave you, let me just show you the main app where you can test the basically the in-app purchases. So let me just select this one and Alex's iPhone and build and run. So you can see how that looks. Okay. There we go. It's fetching all of the in-app purchases. And here you can view or purchase the in-app purchase. So viewing is basically grabbing the data that you have added in App Store Connect to your in-app purchase. And of course, we can take a look at the free categories and we can view it. Let's see. There we go. Let's view. There we go. Of course, we cannot really use this because this is just the main app. We can purchase or we can restore the purchases. That is mandatory. Okay, now that is it for this Rebeloper Messages 13 tutorial documentation. If you have any questions, go ahead and leave them in the comments down below. And as usual, subscribe to the channel, hit that notification bell, and I will see you in the next one.